Welcome back to Accelerate.
Yes, we are excited to be back in church once again.
Whoop, whoop.
We are continuing our new series, Miss Tia. Do you remember what it is?
Yes, we were talking about the fruits of the spirit, Mr. Jared.
That's right, and we're using emojis to do it.
Yes.
Because we're talking about our emotions.
That's right.
And how to use them effectively and how we're supposed to do use our emotions as Christians, right? So, Miss Tia.
Yes.
Last week, what emotions did we talk about? See if Miss Tia was paying attention.
Love.
All right.
And joy.
Very good, Miss Tia. The first two fruits of the Spirit.
I was listening.
That's right. That's right. And we learned about the Joy Hat 4000.
Oh, wow, Mr. Jared.
That's right. I want one so bad.
No.
Could you imagine flying around with that thing?
You don't need a Joy Hat 4000.
I don't need it. I don't need a truck either, but it's nice to have.
No, those are just temporary emotions.
I don't want it for emotion's sakes. I want it because I don't want to sit in traffic.
Yeah. Mr. Jared did not learn anything from our message last
week. I learned a lot, Miss Tia. I learned we were made in God's image.
Okay. You were listening.
I learned that we have emotions just like God has emotions.
Okay. That's two.
I learned that we can't be led by our emotions.
Wow.
Because if God was led by his emotions and he got angry, we'd all be doomed.
Doomed.
So, na-na-na-na-boo-boo, Miss Tia, what'd you learn last week? That's what I thought. Miss Tia trying to throw shade at me. But we are going to continue with our lesson about the fruits of the Spirit. And today's lesson's all about peace.
Peace.
You love peace, right, Miss Tia?
I love peace.
All right, so when I say peace, what do you think of? You want to hear what I think of? You think of the beach?
Yeah. Is that what you were going to say?
I was going to say food, but, you know, whatever brings you peace, right? Well, let's see. When I think of peace, I think of probably like water. Like, I like the sound of water and like waves on the beach.
That's good.
Yep. So, Miss Tia, our friend Micah is going to come and show us again about and teach us about peace, but I don't think these kids are ready.
I don't think they're ready either.
I don't think you're ready, to be honest.
What?
Yeah, I think you need to get a little hype.
I'm always ready, Mr. Jared.
You're ready?
Yeah.
Are you sure?
Positive.
So you don't need a Red Bull.
Or donuts. No.
I bet you take a little bit of worship.
I'll take a lot of worship.
All right, so let's get started.
Okay.
All right, let's get praise and worship kicked off.
Whatever I lose, all I want is to be with you. Wherever I go, whatever I lose, and all I want is to be with you. I want to know your heartbeat, heartbeat.
Come on.
Show me how your heart, I want to know your heartbeat, heartbeat. Show me how your heartbeat, heartbeat. The rhythm of your love is
Beautiful, Miss Tia. Beautiful. Beautiful. I just love worship. I love our worship team.
It's amazing.
And I love worshiping on the big stage.
Wow.
It makes it all like
You're
special.
Right.
So let's continue this day with some prayer.
Okay.
Lord, we thank you for just your peace in our life, Lord, that we get to just experience the peace that comes from heaven and not from just this world, Lord, because that only lasts a little while, but the peace that you bring lasts forever. Lord, we thank you that we get to be peacemakers and bring peace into other people's lives, and that you just sent your son down to earth and we could learn what our lives are supposed to be like through him, Lord. In Jesus' name we pray.
Amen.
Amen, Miss Tia.
So good.
It's good stuff.
Good.
So, mm-hmm. You remember what we're talking about, Miss Tia?
I remember.
What?
Peace.
Peace. That's Ooh. Right. We are learning about peace today
and
what peace is, mm-hmm. how we get peace.
Where it comes from.
Where it comes from.
Mm-hmm.
And a little bit something special right there at the end.
Ooh.
All right. Something a lot of people don't know.
Mm.
But I told you this at the beginning. Our friend Micah is going to come back.
Mm-hmm.
And he's got a little friend with him this time.
Ooh.
And he's a little weird. I'm not going to lie. But he reminds
cool.
he reminds me a little bit about myself.
Yeah. You're a little weird.
Yeah. I was a little crazy.
Mm-hmm.
Especially as a kid. But. Are you ready?
I'm ready.
You ready?
I'm ready to hear from Micah.
Yeah, Micah's cool. I like him. So let's go ahead and go into our video,
mm-hmm.
and we'll be right back.
The fruit of the Spirit. When you have the Holy Spirit, you will produce love, joy, peace, patience, kindness, goodness, faithfulness, gentleness, and self-control. Peace.
Peace! I love peace!
No. Peace, as in the fruit of the Spirit?
That's a vegetable, Micah.
Ah.
Chill out. Have some peace, bro.
Are you worried, anxious, scared of whatever's in your closet? How about the toes that's about to pop out? Now! Well, fret no more with peace.
Peace?
Peace! The truth and knowledge that God is in control over everything will help you overcome the fears of the world, which include toast!
Philippians 4, 6-7 says, don't worry about anything. No matter what happens, tell God about everything. Ask and pray and give thanks to Him. Then God's peace will watch over your hearts and your minds.
I get it now. Through Jesus, I can have peace, so I won't be afraid of toast. I'm as cool as a blue bumper.
Don't you mean cucumber?
Nope.
I am looking for peace.
Peace?
What I really want is peace.
Please?
Oh, won't you listen to my please? Please appease my request for some peace.
Do you need the police, Micah?
All right, that dude was silly. I think he might have missed the whole thing Michael was trying to teach
him. Yeah, I think he confused peas for peas.
Yeah, he must love them. I mean, I can understand. I like me some peas, too. They're delicious.
I don't think so.
You don't like peas?
They're weird. The texture's all off.
All right, well, you need to go check yourself because they're delicious.
Wow.
But Micah wanted to tell us all about peace and what peace is, right?
Mm-hmm.
You know, I did a little bit of research this time, Miss Tia.
Wow, Mr. Jerry.
Yep. Mm-hmm. I got one of them encyclopedia things,
uh-huh.
and I looked it up.
Looked up what?
What peace was.
Oh, what is it?
Well, apparently it's a lot of things. They had like a bunch of different definitions, but this is the one I liked. You ready?
I'm listening.
All right. It says, peace is the freedom from loud, distracting, disruptive, or depressing thoughts or feelings.
Wow, Mr. Jared.
Crazy, Mr.
It goes right in with what we're talking about.
Yeah, all those feelings that are down in there deep are like, but we can all use some peace in those times, right? When all those crazy thoughts are happening and the insides are like turning all crazy.
Yeah, it's all wonky in there.
All wonky. I like that word, Miss T. Yeah. Well, we as Christians know how to get some extra peace, some peace that's not of this world, you know?
You're right.
Mm-hmm. So we know we can go to Jesus.
Yep.
And we have some incredible stories today. We are changing things up.
Yeah.
Because we're not going to have one video.
Yeah.
Micah's not the only one we're going to hear from today. No, we actually going to see what Jesus does.
Ooh.
That's right. But before we get into that, we have to know that we can trust Jesus in any situations, right? Have you ever been in a scary situation or a confusing situation or, I don't know, a chaotic situation? Like, I don't know, maybe you found out a secret that you knew was going to hurt somebody's feelings and you didn't know what to do about that secret.
Yeah, that's heavy.
Or maybe like your friends were fighting or your family members might have been fighting and you're like, I want them to stop fighting, but I don't know what to do.
It's so awkward.
Yeah, and you just like, you feel like all tight on the inside.
Yeah.
So when that happens, we tend to worry, right?
Yeah.
And we want to try to do something.
Yeah.
But we can't, right? Sometimes we just can't do things.
Sometimes we don't know what to do.
Mm-hmm. Well, we can do something, Miss Tia. We can stop.
Mm-hmm.
We can pray.
Yeah.
And we can go to Jesus,
That's
right?
That's so good.
Because he is our peacemaker.
Mm-hmm.
He brings peace into our life, all right, in those situations where we can't do anything about it. So we are going to see a situation where the disciples were freaking out. Like, stuff was going down.
Ooh.
They didn't know what to do.
Thought they were going to die.
And you know what Jesus did or what he was doing?
He was sleeping.
He was taking him a nap when all the crazy stuff was happening.
Wow.
When they thought they were going to die, Jesus was in the boat just
taking a nap.
Yep. So, this is one of Jesus' craziest miracles in my my opinion. It's like one of the craziest things he ever did.
Yeah.
He literally defies nature.
I know.
Defies it.
But he can do that.
With three words.
Three.
Three words, Miss Tia.
Three.
We're going to talk about the story where Jesus calmed the storm.
Mm-hmm.
Are you guys ready? Are you ready, Miss Tia?
It's good. I know
it's good. It's good. So, let's watch this video.
Yep.
And we'll be right back with some more just words about Jesus.
Hey kids, have you ever seen a really big storm? Maybe there was bright lightning, loud thunder, and lots of rain. Did it scare you? In this lesson, we're going to take a look at what happened to Jesus and his disciples when they got caught in a big storm. Jesus and his disciples were caught in a big storm on a lake. They were all sailing across the sea on a boat. When suddenly a big storm hit. There was big waves everywhere and it was getting really dangerous. The disciples were getting really scared and had no idea what to do. The disciples were so afraid that they woke up Jesus. Wait a second, Jesus was sleeping during this huge storm? The huge scary storm that was tossing the boat all over? And he was just sleeping through it? He must have been really tired or must have been really, really relaxed. And you know who wasn't relaxed at all? The disciples. They thought they were about to die. So they woke up Jesus and asked him to help them. Jesus spoke to the wind and waves and the storm stopped. All Jesus had to do was to tell the wind and waves to be still. And they listened. How crazy is that? Jesus can stop a storm by just speaking. After he calmed the storms, the disciples realized that he wasn't just a normal guy. They recognized he was God, and they knew he was worth following. And kids, we can learn a pretty cool lesson from this. Jesus has the power to calm any storm at any time. And that's what the disciples realized. They saw that Jesus was more powerful than anything.
And this story helped them to have even more faith. Memory verse.
Then he asked them, "Why are you afraid? Do you still have no faith?" So kids, next time you get caught in a big storm and you want to run and scream and panic, remember this story.
Whether it's lightning or thunder or hard times, Jesus will calm you through the storm.
Hey, kids and parents. If you want to hear more about fear or faith, check out the links below.
Wow, what a great story, Miss Tia. One of my favorites. Crazy, crazy, crazy.
Right. Such a great story, though.
It is, it is. Mm. So, I know a little bit about storms and boats, Miss Tia. You know why?
Why?
You see, I'm a commercial fisherman. Still licensed and everything.
Wow.
That's right.
You got secrets, Mr. Jerry.
Yep, that's how I paid my way through college.
Wow. Mm-hmm.
So, I know a little bit about how crazy them storms can get on lakes
just
and waters and seas and stuff. Just a little bit.
Okay.
Yep. Just a little bit.
Mm-hmm.
It's a lot of slipping, a lot of sliding, a lot of falling down,
mm-hmm,
a lot of stuff shaking around.
That sounds kind of scary.
Yeah, so I'm not a big fan of storms anymore.
Mm-mm.
I like the rain,
yeah,
but when the wind starts blowing and the lightning starts striking, I start shaking in my boots.
Mm-mm.
Mm-hmm. What about you? You like storms, Miss Tia?
Absolutely not.
Mm-mm.
They scare me.
I know. I know exactly what those disciples were thinking and feeling
there.
Yes. But I still wanted to have been the disciple that went up to Jesus and woke him up from his nap.
Mm-mm.
I bet you that was scary, too.
I'm not doing that.
You know? But because Jesus loves us so much,
yes,
and because he probably still wanted to nap a little bit, he was like, y'all quit talking. Get out
yes.
my way.
Let me handle
And what'd he say? What'd he say? Three words.
He said, peace be still.
Peace be still.
Wow.
And the rain stopped. The wind stopped blowing. There was no lightning, no thunder.
Nothing.
I bet you Jesus just went back to sleep, Miss Tia.
And just like,
yeah. But as crazy as that is,
mm-hmm,
the crazier thing is, Jesus gave us that same power.
Wow.
Yes. When Jesus went back up to heaven, he gave us authority
yes.
over all kinds of things,
mm-hmm,
being the storms of
yeah.
life. Not just natural storms like what's happening. That's like all the storms that happened this week.
Yeah.
Crazy stuff, right, Miss Tia? But the storms that are inside of us with our emotions.
Yes.
So what do we do when those storms happen, Miss Tia? When on the inside we just feel all twisted up and knotted up. What do?
We go to Jesus.
We go to Jesus, just like the disciples
yes.
did. It's that easy.
Mm-hmm.
I want to read you a scripture.
Ooh.
Yeah.
You've been doing some real research,
I've been,
Mr.
Yeah,
Jared.
I like
wow.
this series, Miss T. So this one, this scripture comes from John 14.
Ooh.
That's a good book.
John's good.
And it's verse 27.
Okay.
It says, peace I leave you.
Ooh.
And this is Jesus. You know how I know it's Jesus?
Because it's in red.
Because it's in red. All right, it says, peace I leave with you.
Mm-hmm.
My peace I give to you.
Ooh.
I do not give you the same peace that the world gives.
Wow.
Do not let your hearts be troubled,
mm-hmm,
and do not be afraid.
That's good.
Miss Tia, Jesus can just drop that mic right there.
I know.
I mean,
we're done.
What else do you need?
What else we got to say?
What do we got to do? Me and Miss Tia don't even need a paycheck, right?
I know.
But Jesus loves us so much that yeah. he wants us to live in peace always.
Always.
But not just us, right?
Everybody
we know. Everybody.
Yeah.
So we have a job.
Even our enemies.
That's right. Even our enemies are supposed to have peace. But that peace comes through Jesus.
Yeah.
So we have a job. Me, you, all the people watching.
All the kids.
That's right. We are called to be peacemakers.
Mm-hmm.
We are called to bring peace into other people's lives
That's
by telling
right.
them about Jesus
yes.
and about the love that he has
yes.
and the power that comes through that love.
So right.
Mm-hmm. I know a story in the Bible. It's one of your favorites, Miss Tia.
It's a favorite up there.
You think you want to share it with us?
It's up there with Ruth. It's one of those.
That's one of those. That's right. Miss Tia knows her stuff, guys. So you want to tell us or no?
I'll tell you.
All
yeah,
right, tell us, Miss Tia.
You don't have to beg. I'll tell you. So Mr. Jared is talking about the story about Abigail and David.
Uh-oh.
Y'all know David, right?
Yeah, he's the guy that killed the giant and
yes,
stuff.
Yes, and then cut his head off.
With his own sword.
With his own sword.
That's crazy.
Wow, David's super cool.
Mm-hmm.
Well, today we're going to talk about Abigail and how she was a peacemaker in a hard, hard situation.
Yeah?
Yeah.
What happened?
She was married to a kind of a mean, evil man.
Yeah?
His name was Nabal.
His name was, he was bald?
No, he was Nabal.
Nabal.
Mm-hmm.
Nabal.
There it is. That's what the Bible says.
All right,
I can't argue
all right.
with the Bible
I'll
now.
Trust you. That's a little weird, but all right.
You know what his name meant?
That he's bald?
No.
That he likes the ball?
Nothing with the ball.
Nothing about a ball?
No.
Then I don't know.
It meant foolish.
He's foolish?
His name literally meant fool.
That's crazy, Miss Tia.
And guess how he acted?
I wouldn't like that name.
Like a fool.
Mm-hmm.
He acted just like a fool. And he disrespected David.
What?
Yes.
The David.
The David.
The David that killed Goliath already.
Yes.
I wouldn't. That's not
I
smart.
I wouldn't do that.
That's not smart.
He even tried to play like he didn't know who David was.
Who doesn't know who David is?
I know. Ruth. dude.
The anointed king?
Yes.
He doesn't know who that is.
After David had been so kind and generous to him, he was rude to David.
Uh-oh.
So you know what happened, right?
David fixing to throw them hands.
He got
fixing to get that sling out again.
He was ready to just take out all in the ball and his people.
Oh, yeah. That's my David right there.
But guess what Abigail did?
I don't know. I feel like being a peacemaker, she's going to do what she's supposed to do.
Huh?
Like, and just, like, beat Nabal up?
No.
Oh.
She didn't hurt Nabal at all.
Why not?
Because that's not the right thing to do, Mrs. Jared.
Dang it.
She baked and got a whole bunch of food.
Oh.
Packed it up.
Okay, I like the way where this is going.
And took it to David.
Oh, wow.
Yes. And she went to him and she said, put all the blame of Nabal's bad temper and anger on her.
Remember what I said about food earlier? Food always brings peace.
It brings peace. You're right,
Miss Jared. It's just what it does.
In a crazy situation where Abigail could have been hurt, David could have killed her, she took the blame of someone else to bring peace to her people.
Wait, hold up. What do you mean she took the blame?
She took the blame. She hadn't done anything wrong. She hadn't disrespected David. But she told David, put the blame on me.
She said that.
She said that.
In the Bible, it says.
In the Bible. In 1 Samuel chapter 25, 1 through 44.
Man, that's my kind of woman, Miss Tia.
She, and in the Bible, it says that Abigail was a bright, intelligent, and beautiful woman.
Oh, she's definitely my kind of woman.
She basically saved Nabal's life.
Not just him. The whole
Everybody.
Family, apparently.
Everybody.
Ooh, man. That's crazy,
yeah.
Miss Tia.
She humbled herself, and she didn't allow the fear of what could have happened to her to stop her from doing what God had told her to do.
So you telling me she didn't let her emotions rule her life?
She didn't let them control her.
Man, oh, man, Miss Tia.
What a woman.
What a woman. She is a peacemaker. Just like Abigail and just like Jesus,
yeah.
We're all called to be peacemakers.
Right.
As Christians, we're called to bring peace
to
in a troubled world,
even
right?
to our enemies.
Whenever the storms of life are out there, we have to speak life. We have to speak love and speak peace.
That's
right, Miss Tia?
So good.
So good. Are you ready to go out into the world and spread a little peace?
I felt a little bit filled up in the spirit, if
you
know what I mean.
I do too, Miss Tia. This was a good little rundown.
I know.
So, I hope you guys are ready to stand up for Jesus and spread a little bit of peace out there.
That's right. Mm-hmm. We're so glad y'all came today. We hope y'all enjoyed our Fruit of the Spirit second installment.
That's right.
We'll be back next week talking more about the fruits of the Spirit.
That's correct, Miss Tia.
And we'll see y'all then.
See you then, guys. All right. Bye.